ัสดีค่ะ Welcome to Simple Thai My name is Sticky Thai and then today I'm going to show you how to make Phat Kaprao. Phat Kaprao is really good in Thailand. Very simple, very easy and very healthy. Quick and easy. So I'm going to show you with the Kaprao pork today which means Kaprao Hmu. Okay? So Kaprao Hmu with the fried egg. How about that?So very easy, very quick, simple. So let's do it. What do I need today is I have last episode I show you my simple Thai garden in my house in California, and so now I pick from the basil here, and also they have two different basil here, two different kind that I grow. One is a sweet Thai basil, and then one is Holly's basil, which is very spicy. It have a hint.Heat onto it. So I'm gonna mix together them, and this is from my garden from my last episode, if you know. And then also the chili. So this one is not spicy, but it's also just a hint of kind of garnish and you know, a little taste. So not spicy, but I have my Thai chili that I always buy from the farmer market or free market. Sometimes they come in twice a week.In the summertime, there's a lot, and then I pick them up, clean them, and then I put in the refrigerator. So I mean freezer, so they last long time. So okay, and then I have my onion, I have cover leaf. So let's do it. So I have my sweet basil right here. Oh my god, it's amazing. This one we also use for the curry too. So Phat Kaprao today, okay, with two different kind of basil. Holy basil, which one is really hot.Really spicy, and then another one a little bit sweet. Okay, so I have my let me peel up my my garlic. You can use as much as garlic you want. I love garlic, so top it out like that. The town I grew up in Thailand is southeast. We have a famous garlic, so.Here, of course, we can have that, but those garlic is very tiny, but wow, so strong taste. So now I have my garlic right here. Okay. Then I have my onion. Add a little bit onion here. So I hope you guys are doing really well. It's so beautiful out here in California, nice and sunny.Hope you guys enjoy the sun as much as I do, and cook something very simple meal. You can also can pop, you know, all your the meal. So now I have onion here. If you don't have onion, you don't have to worry about it. Just use the garlic, olive oil. You can make any kaprao chicken, kaprao shrimp, seafood, same recipe, same ingredient.But all choice of meat, okay? Some people love, like vegetarian lovers, then they do with the tofu. It's worked really well too. And with the seafoods, my favorite one also. But today, I make the, show you how to make ground pork, because also very simple and easy to eat. Okay, crop. I need crop. In Thailand, we need to have crop.In your kitchen, you need one of this. It's basically motto, and you actually in there, or whatever the curry paste, and then you pounding. So this is called sa. Kok sa is always together, like a husband and wife, boyfriend, girlfriend. You always have to have, okay? So now you have garlic here. You're pounding the garlic here together.Always say don't break the mortar. So garlic and then chili. So I'm going to make about 1 cup of pork, ground pork. So I add maybe 4-6 chili, but if you like more, you always can add more. Remember, Thai food is always you can add more, and then when you powder the chili, always cover that because you don't want them to go into your eye.Okay, so I set aside. Now I'm pounding my chili and the garlic together. And now I'm going to now I have my set my basil there. So I'm gonna cut some of my the garnish. This is from my backyard. This chili, I hope that tastes really good. The beautiful color. And if you don't have this, you don't need to use. You just use whatever you have, like ground pork, and the ingredient I'm gonna show you, and then basil. And if you cannot, you couldn't find any like a sweet basil or the Hollis basil, you can use either one. Okay. So now, okay, let's do it. I get my pan here. Turn on. So I have a ground pork right here. It's very easy and simple. You go to the grocery and then you tell them, you know, you want the ground pork how you want it. So like that. But if you don't, if you have more time, you can just buy the shoulder pork, you know, pork shoulder, and then cut them whatever the size you want, and then you can, you know, prepare your meal. But this one, quick, easy, and simple. So 2 tablespoons of the olive oil. Okay. This is very easy, simple, less than 10 minutes. Crab meal, and then you can add, you can serve with the rice, or you can serve with the, or you can just eat it. Then you can serve with the egg. Gap pao today, gap pao mu, pork in Thai mean mu. So now I have the garlic and chili already here. Remember, if you love garlic, you always can add more garlic. You love chili, you always can add more. So now, right after, you can see that. Now you just, oh my god, the smell of garlic. This is very easy, simple. Now you just mix all the ground pork. Oh my god, I can smell it already. You can use with the ground chicken or chicken piece or beef or shrimp or seafood or tofu. So olive oil first. You can use any oil too at home if you have, but I prefer this olive oil. Garlic, chili. Then I'm gonna add onion between right here because I want my onion to be like not too overcooked, you know what I mean? So the same time, because I like onion to be like kind of like crunchy, you know. Okay, so between that, now when the pork should, I add a little salt, pinch of the salt, little pinch of the pepper. Now look at that. Oh my god, the smell amazing. This is so easy and so simple, guys. Very healthy for you. If someone loves vegetarian, they can have a tofu or even vegetable. Okay, now I can see the pork is almost cooking. The colors look amazing. I add a little of the cover leaf because I like, you know, the cover leaf, almost everything for my cooking. I think it's just aroma of the cover leaf just make it different. Okay, now I'm gonna add my a little soy sauce. I would say 1 tablespoon soy sauce. The key is the fish sauce. I love this brand, it's really good. I use this one a lot and I can taste different, you know, different, let's see. I can taste it different when I use different brand, but I like this one. So I would say like a 1 teaspoon fish sauce. Oh wow, I can smell it already. And then I would say a little sweet sauce. Just make a little color. One spoon. And then soy sauce, one tablespoon. Remember Thai food, as I mentioned, you always can add, it has to have the element of salty, sweet, sour, spicy. It's all your choice. So taste first. How do you like it? If you think that's not enough spice for you, or it's not enough, you know, spicy for you, you always can add more, okay? Remember that, always remember. All right, so I'm gonna add just a hint of the sugar, just a hint a little bit right there. Oh my God, this one, quick, easy, my hot kapow, pork basil for tonight. Almost ready. Now I'm gonna add basil into it. Wow, I love more basil. This is from my backyard, so I'm just gonna add it all. Two different Thai I cooked today. I made with the sweet basil, and also I add with the, oh my God, the smell amazing. And I add with the holy basil. And now, let's dive. So I'm gonna taste them out a little bit. And now my top with the garnish with the homegrown chili pepper. Wow. This is my pad kapow. Look amazing and smell amazing. Remember, you always can add more. So I turn it off. It's all cooked now. I'm gonna taste first if I need more fish sauce or if I need a little hint of sugar. You can add more, but it look amazing and smell amazing already. Let me taste. Wow, this is perfect. It's perfect. The salt, a little hint of sweet. It's perfect. Everything is so good, and you can see right here, guys. It's ready. This is ready to eat. You can serve. You can serve with the rice, steamed rice, jasmine rice, or you can just eat it by itself with all the vegetable. And also, you can serve with the fried egg. Okay, so I'm gonna set up the plate. We're gonna have with the vegetable to eat today. And I have a sticky rice, so I'm gonna serve with that. How about that? And I'll show you guys how to make a sticky rice, okay? So in my hometown, we eat a lot of sticky rice. Very easy to grab it, very easy to eat it. So simple and easy, ready to go. Okay, let me set up the plate for you. So we can enjoy together. Oh my God, this is amazing. Look at that. And if you have boiled egg, you can have boiled egg, you have fried egg, you can have fried egg on top of this. Look at that. So I cook my sticky rice today, the whole week. So I'm gonna show you later how to make my sticky rice, but today, this one, my sticky rice. And I have my basil here. Pork basil, pad kapow moo. Who fan pad kapow moo, you can add a little with the garnish right here. With cilantro. This is so perfect spice, perfect everything. And I serve with the sticky rice right here, guys. You eat with your hand or you eat with the spoon. Garnish with that. Green onion. This is so good. Very easy, simple, guys. You can prep everything like onion. You know, prep onion, prep garlic. Put in the refrigerator, you have basil. Wow, the spice, the chili is, it's so good for me. And then you can, same recipe. The key is the fish sauce. Number one, fish sauce. And now, here is my ผัดกะเพรา กะเพราหมู Pork basil. So if you like my recipes, please let me know or you have any questions. So share with your friend and family if this is helping you very quick, easy and simple. And subscribe and share and like. Always remember, simple life, happy life.With love, namaste. Enjoy ผัดกะเพราค่ะ สวัสดีค่ะ